4 years after the pandemic first closed schools, educators say they are still seeing more violence in their buildings.
KARE 11 has been tracking the issue, and tonight, investigative reporter Lauren Lemanchek has brand new data from the state on dangerous weapons in our schools.
Afternoon, everybody.
For St. Paul's Johnson High School principal Jamil Payton.
Language. Thank you. That's okay.
The hallway check-ins are about relationships.
Corey.
A sense of belonging.
Hey, good morning.
And school safety.
How big of a responsibility do you personally feel that kids come into this building and they're safe?
I think it's my number one. It's number one for me.
But for some in St. Paul, that safety was shattered last year when a Harding High School student was stabbed to death in the halls. New data obtained by KARE 11 shows it was one of 68 incidents last year in the district where a student was disciplined for bringing a weapon to school, including 5 guns, prompting hard conversations.
Enough is enough.
But not only in St. Paul. In Robbinsdale, outrage after 7 incidents involving guns. That data shows weapons reports in Minnesota schools last year were up. 1,750 incidents, nearly 200 more than the previous year. Assaults increased too. And while gun reports dropped from 70 to 60, they're still far above pre-pandemic numbers. Last year, 45 individual schools confronted a gun on campus in urban, suburban, and rural districts.
What does that tell you as an educator?
For me, it tells me that our children and our families, like, they're hurting right now.
Payton believes we are still seeing residual effects of the pandemic, along with the ease with which school kids can get guns and a rise in crime in communities. Some kids say they bring guns and knives for protection.
If I feel unsafe out on the streets, I may not feel as safe in the schools as I should.
Schools have always had tensions, problems, people get into fights, people get into arguments. But when they're armed, those arguments can escalate and they can become, in some cases, deadly.
James Densley, a nationally known school safety expert, says that's why addressing the underlying issues is more critical than ever.
It's about making kids feel seen and connected in their schools.
An effort Carolyn Berger from the Minnesota School Counselors Association says calls for an all-of-the-above approach.
Sometimes schools' crisis response plans might focus more on what I would refer to as target hardening, things like bulletproof glass and cameras in schools.
Those things are important, she says, and so are counselors, school resource officers, and support staff.
You need to have comprehensive services that help students feel that school is a safe place for them, that school is a place where they belong, and that they are welcomed.
At Johnson High School, student support liaisons monitor hallways and entrances.
Just being vigilant, you know, I check in with students, I have conversations.
Doors are secured with alarms. But central to all of it is building trust.
They feel like, you know, something's going on, whether it's in the school or even in the community. They have that relationship with adults, they'll be more apt to tell them.
Principal Payton can't control what his students face once they walk out the doors. But in this place,
from 8:30 until 3, you have a safe space. You get fed, you have shelter, but more importantly, you have adults that care about you and care about your well-being.
When I first reported on this data last year, school leaders were hopeful that they'd turned a corner. These new numbers just don't bear that out. But there are some positive developments. In Minneapolis public schools, for example, the number of gun reports was down from 30 to 8. Now, in this story, on our website, we do have a drop-down menu where you can search weapons reports at your child's school. For KARE 11 Investigates, I'm Lauren Lemanchek.